Hayden and Dr. Finn, Liz and Franco, Dylan and Kiki, Morgan and Kiki, Nick and Ava, and a vibrator. Hayley Erin is in studio too, coming up next.
You're tuning into the destination for TV superfan discussion, AfterBuzz TV. And now, let the buzz begin.
It's our music. It is Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. Here at AfterBuzz TV, this is your general hospital after show. I have to like tell people to stop. Stop it. Wait, stop it.
You're too good a time.
We're going to turn this car around. This is the GH Report, and I am your host, James Lott Jr. Welcome, and we're happy to have you here today on this Sunday. On the Sunday sub block here at AfterBuzz TV, and we have a full panel and a guest. I'm so excited. Next to me is the girl who spells her name correctly, Lacretia Lyon.
Of course I do, since it's hard for people. And it's L-A-C-R-E-T-I-A-L-Y-N. L-Y-O-N. Oh, even I can't spell it.
You know
where to find me. I need to leave.
And the girl next to her is giving us some executive realness. I'm like, girl, answer the phone, girl, and take a call. Ladine Harvey.
Hi, guys. You can find me on Twitter at Ladine underscore Harvey and on Facebook at Ladine Corinthos Harvey.
And the other half of Link, who is my frenemy, Frank Moran.
If there's any doubt who was bringing home the bacon and frying it up in the pan, we know.
Where can we find you?
You can find me at home waiting for Ladine to bring home the big bucks at Happy Go Jackie.
Is now in the doghouse.
I think it is in the doghouse. Aw, I like dogs. Okay, so we have a guest today, and she's already so lovely and fun. And we've been just chit-chatting before the show even came on. She looks good, too, folks. Wait till you see her outfit. She's so cutesy. She plays Kiki, of course, and we're so happy that she is in here with us. Mm-hmm. Hayley Erin.
Hey, guys.
Hey, this is the
It's like a party. Yes.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming on this hot ass Sunday in Los Angeles.
That is accurate.
Yes. Now, folks out there, you can follow us on YouTube and iTunes under the General Hospital After Show, even though we're all called the GH Report. You can find us there. Like us, rate, comment. We do comment back, of course. And then we have the hashtag ABTVGHReport on Twitter and all of our handles. And even to Hayley, you can always talk to her, too, on there, too. And now, it makes me laugh every time this portion of my announcements to this side of the table. We're at 1250-something, I think, on Facebook. We're trying to get to 2,000 likes.
And yeah, Frank doesn't think we can get there.
And Frank doesn't think we can get there, but we can.
We will get there. Yeah.
We're going to die before we get there. I know it.
We
I
have to it. Get there before September 27th.
Okay. Yeah. Challenge. Okay.
Before sure. our 1 year.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's
or,
a challenge.
Or what?
The show will implode. This is what happened. We're at the end of the world.
We need some motivation. We got to,
yes.
You know.
Okay. I'm working with Lady on that one. So you guys are liking. We had some new likes this week, so thank you very much. You guys are following us, and we really appreciate that. Let's get started. So we're going to talk with Hayley a little bit first. And how did you find General Hospital? How did it come to you?
It was just another audition, you know? Mm-hmm. They throw them at you, and I, on the way over here, I was thinking, acting is a lot like being a NASCAR driver, except you spend more time in your car when you're an actor.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Here in LA, yeah.
Yeah, it's awful, but it was a great audition. Yeah. I went in and I met with Mark Teschner, who is the bomb.
The man.
And I went in the first time, met with him, read the scenes, it went well, came back again. Okay. Came back again. Oh, came really? Back again. Oh, came really? Back a bunch of times. And then I actually left on the last audition, and they gave me a call when I was like a block away and told me I got the part.
Wow.
Yeah. So I drove back over.
Back in the car.
Yes. And I had a wardrobe fitting, and then I started like that next Monday. It was insane. Wow. Yeah, that was on a Thursday. It was like wham, bam. Thank
wow.
you.
Wow. Who'd you test with? You don't remember?
With Brian.
Oh,
yeah,
Brian.
Of course. Yes. Yeah, it was really funny. We did a bunch of scenes that took place in the apartment. They were actually scenes that he had done with Kristen Alderson.
Okay, okay.
And I guess the set wasn't available on the day that I went to do the test. So we did those scenes in the hospital.
Oh, how funny. Oh,
wow. Yeah, I'm talking about like the poker game I'm setting up.
Yeah.
It was hilarious. It only threw me off a little bit.
Yeah, I'm sure. Just sit around. So you're like, okay, I got to it's an apartment.
Yeah.
Not the hospital. Not the General Hospital.
No.
Right.
Well, you bring up Kristen's name. So you took over the role for that. So the first time we've ever had somebody on the show that's taken over and reprised a role from somebody else. So what was it like for you when you get that? Does GH give you any info on that, or do you just make all the choices once you get the side about who you think this character is?
That's a great question. I started off on the show, I mean, almost 2 years ago now. Wow. Kind of crazy.
Oh, my God.
I watched a lot. I went back on YouTube, and I probably watched like 100 episodes, not wow. joking. And at that point, I kind of decided that I wasn't going to let the fact that I was the second Kiki control my performances. Okay. And I figured I was just going to be myself and kind of give it my own spin, because everyone's going to put their own personality into the part. So I figured I wouldn't try to be someone else. And it's worked out pretty well for me, I think.
We agree.
Thank yeah. you. Yeah. It can be difficult sometimes, yeah. story-wise line, yeah. when there are things that I refer to that I wasn't there for. And I Google or I ask someone on set, right. like, hey, you guys, what's that about? but other than that, yeah. I mean, I feel like it was a pretty seamless beginning for me.
Well, I feel like you came alive once you hit with Dylan, I think. To me, it felt like once you and Robert Palmer bumped into each other, that scene where you bumped into each other, I think all four of us, yeah. we don't agree on everything. And that's when a few times we agreed, we're like, hey, you're in that wheelchair, and he comes by and starts talking, we're like, wait a minute, there's something there.
Right.
And like, you came alive.
Yeah, because at first, you know, I wasn't too sure about, you know, your character. I didn't really like her too much, and a lot of people in the chat room didn't really care for Kiki all that much.
I understand.
But where you're headed right now, I'm liking it.
Thank you.
Before, you couldn't pay me to like you.
That's so funny. I'll be honest, there were moments that I didn't like Kiki very much. She's done some questionable things, mm-hmm. and as a viewer of the show, because I watch the show,
yeah.
it's hard to support someone who's, you know, going back to a guy that slept with her mother or drugging her ex-boyfriend slash boyfriend's brother.
Are you going back to Morgan? Is that what you just said?
Before. Yeah.
Okay, I thought she was, you know, trying to slip by a little bit.
Don't do that to me. Are you trying to get me in trouble?
She's all, just us watching. No one's here. Just us.
Well, because we saw from Friday's episode, certainly you've done more
yes,
than that
exactly.
we've seen, but yeah. you end up saying, all right, we'll try going out again, Morgan, see yeah. what happens with that. For you, that too seems to be the frustration with maybe yeah. a lot of fans yeah. as well. It's just that they're just caught in this orbit, Morgan and Kiki. So how's it been for you just maybe feeling some of that frustration as an actress, but then saying, all right, no, I've got to be able to justify this as a character?
It's not easy all the time because I have my own personal opinions about the story and the character. And I do think that it's very weak for a woman to keep returning to a man who has repeatedly embarrassed her and shamed her. It's yeah. sad. But you have to look at the storyline and you have to look at the character and you have to justify it, because I don't get to write the show and I don't get to change the things that I don't like, but I have to make it work. So now I think it's a lot easier because Morgan has gone to Friedman. Morgan has worked on himself. He's worked through his issues. And now, looking back on the whole relationship, he's been bipolar. He was undiagnosed. And now, going forward, I think his actions will have to be held accountable.
Right. Even though he has gotten this treatment, he will have that for the rest of his life.
Right.
So that's something that Kiki also have to take into account when you go back to Morgan, is that something may happen again down the line, and are you willing to put up with it again?
I think so. I think that she doesn't love him because he's bipolar, or she doesn't take into consideration the bipolar. I think it's about Morgan as a person, and she's accepted the fact that he has this condition, but it's not going to control their relationship.
Right.
It's not going to make her leave him,
right.
and it's not going to make her stay with him. But I do think at this point that she's trying to give him a fair chance.
Again.
Well, this is funny. Sarah Hawk says, and I've heard this before, I love Hayley. I really, really like Dylan and Kiki, but I still think Hayley would have been a better Serena Baldwin. Hayley looks just like Carly Schroeder, who played her.
I love her. She was on my favorite show, Lizzie McGuire.
I know. She was.
I'm honored every time I read that.
She was. So it's kind of funny. So people like you as an actress. They like this. The Kiki character now is taking off. People are like, yes. I mean, really, you and Dylan, I swear to God, I think changed it all around.
It's fun because Rob and I are friends in real life, yep. and we get to play on that. And when I started on the show, I didn't know anyone. And now, obviously, Brian and I are friends. Yep. But starting playing a relationship with someone who you don't know can be a lot trickier than pretending to like someone who you like.
Yeah.
So now that we have that kind of relationship, and I think it shows through on camera. And
we're gonna bring them on together.
Yes. I think we've seen that chemistry through all your interactions, but I thought one that really stood out was the nurse's ball when you and Robert were singing.
Yes.
Just like that, just the acting for that, where you guys just, for you, just like that moment where you guys like,
smile.
What is,
That was so much fun. And when they gave us the song, we worked on it and we got our choreography. And what's so funny is that when we were choreographing it, you know, we decided that we were going to look at each other on certain lines and that I was going to hold the look or he was going to hold the look or whatever it was. Yeah. And we actually did it and they told us like, you guys, you got to dial that down. That was a little like, that was a little over the top. Could you just do that? But like -5. Like, okay.
I think everyone, there's another everybody agreed, like, that was such a cute, good number. We all like that again. Yes. Fans did too.
Thank you. I was nervous about it. I'm not a singer or a dancer.
But you're with him, who is a singer.
Yeah, and
stuff,
exactly. He is such a nice guy. Yeah. He just made me feel at ease, and I just let myself loose. It was
that performance is what made me say I'm all for Kiki and Dylan.
Because
I was all for you and Morgan. Like, you couldn't tell me nothing with these people.
Because
I felt that you and Morgan had, like, a really nice emotional connection. And
it was that, like, Romeo and Juliet
right.
kind of deal.
So
that
if Romeo banged your mom. Yes.
I mean, we don't know. Shakespeare just might have left that part out.
That was in the director's cut.
Well, let's go right in, because the first storyline I was going to talk about is Kiki and Dylan, the sickly first date. Let's go right into that. They made you sick. There's always like something happening, and they made you sick.
I mean, nothing can go right. That would be no fun.
What's the best way to play sick, though?
Before I know.
You read the script, like, all right, Kiki's getting ready for a date, but oh, you also have a cold.
I'm not gonna lie, the entire car ride to work that morning, I fake sneezed like the whole way there. And I was nervous about it. And actually, Frank Valentini, he directed those scenes. And that morning when we blocked them, he was like, so Hayley, you think you can fake sneeze? And I was like, actually, like, I've been working really hard on it. So that part's a little tricky because sometimes it can sound a little fake and dismal, but I worked on my sneezing, I worked on my coughing, and then you just got to do like the stuffy nose. But then she takes some medicine and she gets better. So by the time she got to the hospital to talk to Morgan, I was like, we're just going to drop
so much
that.
Better.
Yeah.
But here's the thing, you were like the prettiest sick person. I'm like, the cute red dress is like, makeup on.
You know what's funny? I would have said something about that and it would have bothered me, except that it was written in that I had like worked really hard to put on my face.
That's what I thought.
You did say
that.
You did say that.
Like, even though she was sick,
she's
probably going to leave it,
up
to him. Like, you know, do you still want to go out even though I'm sick? Yeah. Or...
General question for the room, though. What are everybody's rules on making out with the person when they're sick? Because I'm feeling like,
me
don't know.
Too. I'm like,
fear warning, I think.
I used to be a nurse. So I was always told that you're most contagious when you're catching the cold. So if you actually got the cold already, the misnomer
said,
go ahead and make out. I almost cussed. I caught myself. I caught myself, Alexis. But you can actually, you won't really get sick. But when you're catching it, that's when you're most contagious. So I was trying to figure out where, if you were just catching it, or that's where I'm at, Frank. I was like,
let's go with day two.
Okay, maybe that's how.
But some people just don't care for real.
I know they don't.
I wouldn't care.
Okay.
I wouldn't
care.
I'm
kind of gross.
It's like, well, it's Robert, so sure.
Yeah, okay. I was going to say, let's put this in perspective.
Yeah,
the
two of you are just too cute, you know?
Yeah, I guess so. That's a good question. I like that. So you guys are having this cute little date. He decides to go out and get you some medicine and some chicken soup and stuff.
So cute.
And it's very, very nice. He's the good guy.
Don't forget the candle.
And the candle. Yes. He brought a candle. That was so cute. Now, wait. So are you doing that apartment by... No, you and Nina living together right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I figured that out for a second, because I was like, who's living in that apartment?
Right.
So it's you and
Nina. Oh, no, it's Franco.
He's still there, too?
Franco left her.
That's right.
At the apartment.
Okay, that's right. So then Morgan comes over, of course.
Yeah.
But everybody was cordial to each other. It was kind of funny. It was like, you know, Dylan and Morgan were nice to each other. I mean, how do you guys feel about that?
it does show that Morgan has matured. I will say, the way that he handled his scenes this week shows that, you know, Dr. Maddox has really helped him. Mm-hmm. So I did like that, because I do get tired of them always going back to, oh, Morgan's out of control, you know, because that's not how everyone who's bipolar is, you know.
He was calmer.
Yeah.
Was.
I agree.
Yeah.
And certainly Dylan was so stand up in all those scenes, even after Morgan left.
Oh, he's such a good guy. It like hurts. It hurts. He's so cute and good.
But what do you think for Kiki? Do you feel like, all right, she wants to give this shot with Morgan, another go around, but is it always, now it's a little different than before, is that she's been out with Dylan, she's seen what is possible to be with somebody that maybe doesn't come with all that baggage for a relationship. Do you think that's always going to be kind of just sitting there in the back of her mind?
For sure. I think that she's definitely torn a little bit because she cares deeply about Morgan. They've been through so much together, and let's admit it, we've all been in those kinds of relationships where you go around in a circle and everybody else can see that it's incredibly unhealthy, but you're in love, and that's all that matters.
It's true.
So I think a lot of people can relate to that, but now with Dylan in the mix, she's obviously crushing on Dylan, but she feels a sense of obligation towards Morgan. Yeah, because they've been through a lot together, and you know, the whole family deal, Avery, there's a lot of moving parts to it. So I think she's just trying to figure it out.
And that guy, of course, was like, he would have never made it without you. That whole time in Freedom was like, lay that on her.
Exactly. There's a lot of guilt tripping going on.
Exactly.
Yeah, and do you feel that Kiki went back to, was actually going to choose Dylan in that moment until that guy came up?
That's an interesting thought.
Well, that's a good idea.
Yeah, because when she gets off the elevator, it's, we need to talk about this.
Yeah, exactly.
It's not like, I came for you. You know?
Like she normally is with Morgan.
Exactly. Yeah. Like, on her knees.
You were determined. You were, like, determined to talk to him. That's a good question, actually.
Yeah, that's how I saw it.
But that guy was like, he just went, never, my God. When he was like, you're famous at Friedman. I'm like, oh, my God.
Yeah, there was a little bit of that talk, too. Like, we have our good times, and then it's also kind of really horrible sometimes. So.
Yes.
Yeah, an R. Melvin fan in the chat says, your outfit is cute.
Thank you, R. Melvin. I appreciate it. Can you catch the shoes? Yeah. The shoes are my favorite.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, they just pulled
together. Like, poke an eye out.
Yeah. You see me, I'm like, okay.
Yeah, they're cute. They're cute.
Thank you.
So, yes, that's, I mean, so I guess at this point we just see that she's going to go out with Morgan on a Friday night, but then there's Dylan talking to Nina. Which, I don't know, I see chemistry between Nina and Dylan, too.
I do, too, but I would hate for
them to do that. Sorry, girl, I do see it a little bit. I'm like...
You know what's so sad is that, like, I get a little jealous.
So do you go back and watch these episodes?
Oh, yeah.
Oh. So you see how it turns out on
camera.
Does that
make you work a little bit harder?
Oh, yeah. It really does. And I think that's why I watch it, is because, I mean, and like you said in the beginning, you weren't a huge fan. Mm-hmm. Like, watching the episodes as they air, I can see a lot of the things. Like, oh, I probably shouldn't be, like, scratching my nose or, like, whatever the weird thing that I'm doing. Right. And, like, I can catch things that I don't notice that are, like, kind of, I don't want to say tics, but, you know, the little awkward things that people do.
Yeah.
Again, to me, it's just like, I do see the chemistry with Nina and Dylan, but could they do...
I was just going to say, but
could they do that to you again? I'm like, because she's sort of a motherly big sister figure, and I'm like, that would be so wrong.
That would
be
wrong.
Ugh, no.
But maybe it would be so wrong. It's almost right.
That is kind of true. But she gave him good advice. It was like, don't just give her up so easily.
I love that.
Me too. She was like, you can still be a nice guy. Just like, don't give her the option to be like, bye, see you later.
For the woman you want.
Yes. Because she kept saying, what does she mean to you? What does she mean to you? Like, more just to hang out as friends. I love their talk together. She was being really real with him.
Yeah, I love them.
You know.
I saw a lot of projection there on that conversation.
Oh, there was. Those
were great scenes. Those scenes.
They were, because you're talking about Franco and her, of course. Right. Let's talk about that one, kind of. It's like, so do we want, because he also kissed Liz.
Whatever's going to get us less of Roger Howard thrust as a pirate.
Oh, no,
are you kidding? I loved it.
Oh,
I loved it.
Oh,
was a sexy pilot, wasn't
he? He was.
No. What? No. That was so cheesy.
Oh, my gosh.
Cheesy.
But the Fabio hair was amazing.
He had, like, this weird little accent, like, I'm here to...
He looked, like, straight off the cover of a romance novel.
I know.
It was impressive.
Oh, it's so funny. I love it.
He brought back his old hairdo as Todd.
As Todd's lip, yes. I loved it. It's so funny. But so here's the thing. So we got... Dylan and Nina are talking, and like you said, there's a lot of subtext in there because she's talking about her and Franco at the same time. So, I mean, Dylan and Nina are becoming friends. They're friends. They're friends. So that's kind of happening. But then he's at giving a toaster to Liz.
Yeah.
So, yeah, there's a nice toaster. It was a nice toaster. You see, it was a dough of my own. I was like, I want one of those in my house. Making peanut butter toast. It sounded good to you. I was like, that sounds good.
And Jake was just so excited. Like, it's been a while since we've had toast, huh?
I was like, man, peanut butter toast.
It's not that hard to find toast.
I'm like, Jake, you were on Cassadine Island. This is exciting to you. This is exciting to you. So, but then there's this whole, like, she's defending him kind of to himself. And suddenly they kiss. I mean, how do you feel about that?
Well, I felt like he went for the kiss. I mean, she didn't pull back, but he was the one that made the move. Even though later on, he's like, well, when you trying to kiss me?
Well, don't get close. Don't get close.
Oh, yeah.
She's they like leaning.
Kind of
and he was leaning. Yeah, kind
he
of.
Leaned a little more, but.
Yeah. We need to do like a play by play, like with the markers.
Get that clip up and some, ESPN stuff here.
Some sports center.
Oh, my God. And right here is where I leaned in a little bit more.
I'm just glad that they tapped it, you know, because I was just talking about, they didn't go too far, you know, and I like that. They're going to go slow, but I know there's going to be something.
Boo69B says, when Franco kissed Elizabeth in a weird way, I wanted them to get together. When they kissed, I had both hands on sides of my face, says, I cannot look at it.
I really like them together, but my only issue is how this is going to hurt Nina, and I love Nina. Nina's like my new favorite character.
I love Nina
especially
too.
Their scene with Maxie, but we'll get to that later.
We'll get to that. So, but just like it's this musical piece, like it's kind of like he kind of likes her too. I mean, Franco likes Liz, but he still feels for Nina. I mean, it's just.
I will ship Franco and Nina till the day I die.
So you're there. So that's your stance.
I ship it hard.
Okay.
They're your family.
Yeah. They are your family.
You're your little family.
Aside from that, they're just beautiful.
Yeah.
So, one thing about Michelle Stafford we wouldn't know about. Which you do on set.
What about her?
One thing we wouldn't know about.
One thing you wouldn't know about.
That's you know from working with her.
And she's an open book.
I know. It's kind of a hard one.
I was hoping to see if you have something that
I have one. She oftentimes uses a Tim Hortons mug.
Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, Tim Hortons,
That's all I got.
That's good. I have one at home.
See, because we're both non-Canadians who love hockey, so that's so funny, because I'm really into Tim Hortons coffee, too. See, I can't talk to you.
Yeah, when she was here, they talked about that when she was here. We love Michelle. Roger Howarth, one thing about him that we wouldn't necessarily know.
That's a hard one.
Well, no, not people know a lot about him, though. That's the thing.
He's secretive.
He's very secretive. Like we love him.
He has a really cute puppy.
Puppy.
Oh, he's a really cute puppy.
Okay.
That's a good one.
Brings a set?
No, he just shows me pictures.
Aww.
Yeah.
Like, who is her father? We don't know yet, do we?
No, yeah.
Yeah. It's,
oh, yeah, he's really dead.
Yeah, Silas.
Yeah,
he's like super dead.
No.
Yeah.
He's Dr. Finn. That's right, Dr. Finn. Yeah. Okay,
guys, so, but not.
Is that weird to see them come back on the show? Michael Easton come back on the show and he's not your dad?
It hurts a little, but it's awesome having him back. He's such a nice guy, and it's cool just to have him around. So I'll take what I can get.
You get all of it. So let's go into actually Hayden and Dr. Finn. Love those scenes.
Yeah, they were really cool.
With Roxy, we can't forget Roxy. Service.
Anything that's going to get us a little closer, finally, you know, moving along with what's going on with Dr. Finn.
He's dying.
Yeah.
Great. My interest in this story.
I love great. Yeah, I love the scene in the floating rib, because when she whipped out her phone, I was like, oh my God, that's so relevant to now. That's what people would do. Oh my God, I'm filming you. Yeah, yes. don't make fun of this handicapped person. I know I pulled that too, so I can't judge, but at least mine's a dog.
I just love Hayden and Finn together. I think Rebecca Budding and Michael Easton have a little chemistry.
Yeah, they're fun. And it's Rebecca Budding's birthday, by the way, guys. Oh. So let's wish her a happy
birthday, Rebecca.
Happy birthday, Rebecca.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. We love her. But I like that she's a different person with him.
Yeah, it's nice when you see somebody that's so associated with one particular storyline or character. Mostly, I mean, we've got her with Curtis and with Nicholas. But so it's nice to kind of see her broaden horizons and interact with other people.
I agree. So I guess he's dying and he's doing some kind of protocol. Then, of course, we have Maxie, Nathan, and Griffin.
Now, that's the best triangle as far as looks goes right now. Like, to me, I'm just like, oh, wow, because those two, you know, I love my dark hair and blue eyes, so I wish I was Maxie right now.
Can we just get on with this story? Oh, what did you want to tell me? What I was like, Nathan, please just leave.
And have we gotten, I feel like we're pretty much used to the age where people do co-ed bathrooms, or they live on co-ed floors at college. Like, for her, for Maxie to walk into the locker room and like, oh, my can't look.
Always naked. I always have naked.
Your priestliness.
So how did you feel to be a priest? We had laughs over that this whole time. That everybody, oh, my God, you're a priest. I mean, everybody reacted so crazy. They thought he was a priest.
I mean, he's a doctor and a priest.
Yeah.
He's a lot on his plate. I don't know. That's kind of crazy.
Yeah, well, and he's beautiful. So.
Yeah, exactly. That must be rough.
Well, I'm waiting for the scene with Kiki to run up to him and say, you're a priest?
You're a priest.
I've never talked to you before, but you're a priest?
Tell me you're a priest.
Actually, he was my doctor.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
That's right.
I had like a half a page scene with him.
Oh, that's right.
And I loved every second of it.
Matt Cohen is the bomb.
He is the bomb.
We're trying to get him in here, too. We're trying to get him in here.
Oh, he's a cool dude.
Yes.
Yeah. He's a very sexy dude, you know, especially now that he's a priest. But next,
you just want what you can have.
I know. That's what I like, you know. But, yeah, apparently it's Perry Shin's birthday, too.
It is.
We'll wish him a happy birthday as well.
Happy birthday, Perry.
Yeah. Actually, this is his birthday today. And he'll be on next week. He'll be here on next week, so we're excited. Okay, so, yeah, so they didn't tell anything, obviously. But now Maxie's happy. Because she was telling Nina that she's happy, she's going to be married, she's going to forget about Claudette.
Mm-hmm. But it's like, Maxie feels like it's like the end of her life. She's like, I'm not going to be alone ever again. Like, you're, what, maybe late 20s, Maxie? Chill out, lady.
I love that line. I thought it was great.
I know. It's like, and poor Nina, she's like, I'm going to be alone, and nobody's going to be with me. And I'm like, oh my God, that's kind of... But actually, I found that to be a real conversation for Nina. Again, some realism, because she lost 20 years of her life. And she was now older, even with the younger mind, which must be just crazy. And she's thinking, I can't have a baby. I broke up with my man. I mean, she's probably feeling that. Like, I'm not going to find anybody, I'm sure.
Until they got the gift.
Let's talk about that for a second. They never said vibrator. They said sex toy.
Yep.
But when it was buzzing, we all knew what it was. And we couldn't see the box. We saw the back of the box. We're like, oh my God, all those attachments.
They were really trying not to show up that box.
I know. I'm kind of surprised they did. I mean, this is like daytime. I'm like so surprised. It caught me off guard.
Finally, that storyline we've all been waiting for.
Talking about self pleasure.
Yes,
apparently.
There you go.
Dildos in daytime.
Hashtag that.
Is good, Hayley. That's
what I'm here for.
That's my quote of the week. That's my quote of the week. But it's just crazy how they decide to make this a storyline, kind of. It's kind of comical, kind of educational, I guess. So I just want to bring that up because it was kind of a first on Daytime. I never seen them talk about sex toys. I've watched Daytime for years. I've never seen them talk about sex toys before. Which you saw, The Gift. They wrote there, The Gift.
You're going to be shipping that vibrator to Nina soon.
I just love how Michelle played that scene when Dylan walked in and she like fell off. That is like so perfect.
Well,
he's all,
is that the kingdom come? How'd he know?
And I love how Nina not only asked Dylan about using it with you, but Maxie about using it with her little brother.
Yes.
Wait, never mind. I don't want to know.
That was fine.
I was just like, this is really interesting they're doing that. This is very interesting. What also was funny is Nina, speaking of Nina, falling on top of Julian.
That was so awful. That was
so
cheesy.
Are they trying to put them together too? I'm like, I'm feeling that they're trying to put her and Nina, them together too.
They don't know what they want to do.
I think everyone's just kind of, it's a free for all.
They're trying to find chemistry.
Except for Dr. Griffin. You know, he's the only one who's not in this whole free-for-all since he's a priest.
But I couldn't quite understand what the whole context of that scene was. She wants to try to pose for, you know, the all the salute.
Real man.
Yeah. But then what was she trying to, like, tackle him or pose him?
No, she was trying to, like, show him how she wanted him to pose. Let me put you on your knees, because he didn't want to get on his knees. So she wanted to take him down. Let me show you. And then they kind of just fell.
There you go. I get on my knees for you.
I see chemistry there too, kind of. So I don't know. I see it there too.
Yeah, I think they would be funny, and it would bring back, you know, the Julian that we like. That's really funny because William DeFry is hilarious, and this whole storyline I'm not liking because it's like, okay, where are we going? I mean, I'm cool with him killing people, even though I love Carlos, but it's just this darkness that I'm like, in the slick back hair.
Oh, I love the hair.
Well, he's your Uncle Julian. Yeah. It's really funny because they brought Carlos back as a ghost, or kind of his
conscience. Yeah.
His conscience. Hmm. Say, kill Alexis?
Yeah.
Like, what? Huh? What? And he's like, no, I can't kill her. She loves me. I love her. I'm like, what?
For his stages, that scene was. It was nice to see him have a chance to kind of just, you know, show a lot of emotion and range in that, which I felt like sometimes we don't get to see that.
Yeah.
I feel like they only did it to show Julian's point of view as an actor, like, because we always say, you know, he's a bad person, but it gave him a chance to explain himself almost. But then they incorporated Carlos so that we could kind of get, you know, what's going on in his mind.
Yeah, I really love scenes like that where you get to see the perspective of a character who is more guarded and turned off. We don't really get to see Julian express a lot of his feelings, and this is it. Like, you know, he's talking about how he felt about Alexis and all this. So, yeah, this is really bothering him, but we just don't get to see that because he's all macho about it.
Ruben DeVry is a delicious Canadian, they're writing in here.
Oh, yeah, you know, I agree.
Go on, Maxi Forever. She's like, delicious Canadian.
Yeah.
Tasty. let's go into that. I mean, Alexis is going. I actually got a little teary-eyed at the scene when Diane comes in, and she's like, what the hell happened? They go through the whole thing, and Diane does her whole kind of speech, like, I'm going to really fight for you, I'm going to do this. And then she grabs her hand, they hold hands, and I got a little teary-eyed, because they have a long-time friendship.
I love that, and I love seeing Carolyn Hennessy anytime.
We had her in the show, too. Yeah. We love her also. We love her.
She's awesome.
But seeing those two together, a true friendship, a true female friendship, which you'll see very much on Daytime. See them together, she's going to be her lawyer, and Diane's always good. And she's gonna fight for it, but I just thought that scene when they held hands and it's like sister, I'm gonna be here in this with you. I'm gonna be in this with you, and we're gonna work this out together. Because we all know she didn't do it. Everybody in the world knows she didn't do it. We know it's Julian. Everybody knows it's Julian.
But you know, I'd say I forgot.
The dagger. But I'm like, okay, try that again.
Jordan, the way her line was like, oh, we made the correct arrest on the evidence that we had at the time. But I feel like she's really...
Jordan is making me upset.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really not liking Jordan these days. She's getting a little too stick up her butt right now. Okay. I'm like, girl, like, chill.
See, I'm the opposite. Yeah. I'm liking that Jordan started...
Are you
started,
serious?
I
get out of here, James.
Okay, bye.
I'm done.
I'll do another show later. No, but no. Here's my rebuttal to that.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
I like that. Jordan's trying to hold control. She's in charge. She is head bitch in charge at that place. Everybody's trying to usurp her authority.
No, she's
trying to hold on to it.
She's only trying to hold her place because she feel like Anna gonna take it over.
Anna?
I think this is all about Andre. When it's pertaining to Anna, I think it's just all about Andre.
Oh, yeah.
I feel like it's bleeding into her work. Now she wants to be in charge. No, I don't buy it.
No, Jordan has a job to do. She is head in charge, and she's to stand her ground with people.
Well, she should have been doing that from the time she got on then.
Well, now she got stuff going on. I mean, now there's not some real stuff going on there.
Well, I did like the scene with her and Sonny. That was interesting where she got up all in Sonny's business. Is that one of your favorite scenes?
Yeah, I actually did like that one.
I like that one too.
I was like, okay, she put him in his place a little bit.
She did.
You know, around, you know, with your coffee hat. I was like, okay, I'll give it up.
Yeah, because
you know it's true. You know it's true.
I'll give you that one.
But that's it. She had to read Sonny. She had to read Sonny for a second. Like, I don't go to your place to do what you do. She's like, you know.
You know, but the thing is, she was so firm on what she was saying, and then you know, the moment Julian and Alexa, it's like now she was trying to pair up with Anna. It's almost like, no, go back in your office and just not say anything else and let, you know, don't be trying to figure things out now. No, you have your opinion, stick to it.
And Kimberly Howard is commenting on how we're agreeing. Yeah.
These are all great.
It happens
sometimes. Happen often.
Yeah. It happens sometimes.
Everything that killed me about that scene, though, was when Mira Lomax showed up.
Mira Lomax.
I'm about to leave.
Mira Lomax. He came in. Like, where did he dig her out of? I forgot she was on the show. I love some Sherry Belafonte, but all about that. But I was like, oh my God, where'd she come from? And she was, I want her in jail, no bail, nothing.
Yes, just because she embarrassed me. She embarrassed my
boob gates.
Right.
Yeah. No.
Yes. I mean, how could we forget?
I know. That, you can stop laughing. That whole thing was hilarious. Oh, my God. But, yeah, so she was back trying, and it's like, no. And she was like, it didn't work out. And Paul, I think Paul did it on purpose, didn't he?
Yes.
Yeah, he did it on purpose.
Yeah, I think he did. And I kind of like that he threw it on purpose. I like Paul.
I like Paul, too. No. Do you guys believe that Paul is this person?
There was no way it's not Paul. Yeah.
Oh, it is Paul. Yeah, and we're on a blind date, of course.
Right.
So Soy, it's him. I didn't
it is him. Yeah. I know it's him.
What do you think? Think it's him?
And he's
so
funny.
Yeah.
Okay,
he sent her flowers and everything. Yeah,
I mean, that one time they were at, whose place were they at? It was the two of them, and they were being all cute. Whose house was that?
I think it was Anna's house.
It was Anna's house, yeah.
Yeah,
they were just like all sorts of hot.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, she's fighting.
That's all it takes for me to like ship them. I'm like, you look beautiful and make children.
I would actually really like to see Paul and Anna.
Okay.
I would like to see that.
Again. Yeah.
It's a great
hot older couples. They look amazing together.
Over Anna and Andre.
Not over that. Yeah.
Oh, she said not
over
that.
Well, I want to see it. Oh. Over Andre.
Okay.
You know, Andre played with her too much. Mm. He in love with Jordan, so he could. He can have her, but Paul and Anna, I want to see it.
Oh, okay. Okay, very good.
Yeah, I think I would like to see the triangle between Anna being fought over by Andre and Paul. Because we all know that this Jordan thing is going to fizzle out because he really loves Anna. And they're so good together.
Mm. Cheryl, I agree with you. I love Sherry Belafonte, and I loved her on Hotel and all these things. I like her as an actress, but like the Mary Lomax just makes me want to hate her.
And Nexi Forever's waiting for you to let a cuss word out about her.
Shoot.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you. I'll be thrown out. I'll be thrown out. So that's going. Basically, it's a big mess. Yeah.
But the nice thing if Anna did get together with Paul is that then she'd be butting heads with Tracy as well, which would kind of another example of somebody taking over her man.
Anybody with Jane Elliott, anything with Jane Elliott, we're happy about.
Agreed.
Yeah. Okay. So it's
done.
Done. Anything with Jane Elliott in the scene, we're like, just go for it.
Yeah. You guys need more scenes together.
Yes.
So. Right. I loved those scenes where she walked in on us kissing. I thought that was like the greatest day of my life.
It's like the looks on her face, the comments.
The shade. She's like, Kiki Jerome.
When did that happen?
She did say that was so funny. And then my new favorite comedic duo.
Yes.
Nicholas and Ava, your mother.
Love it.
They're hilarious. Yeah. I love their scenes together.
I'm wondering how this would play, though, if Tyler Christopher was still doing it, because it feels like the different actor playing it gives it a whole different kind of dynamic.
Okay, I can see that. Okay, I can see that.
Well, to me, their chemistry was there in the scenes before he had to go off. And so, I think it would be good, because Tyler is funny in real life. I don't know if you guys have ever met him, but he is fun. So I would love to see a fun side of Nicholas come back. Like, you know, because he's always playing the dark
so prince. Serious. Yeah.
Most of my quotes of the week were from them. And there was one where he was like, well, you used to be a criminal, so you know how to open a door. He's like, she's like, I was a mobster, not a cat burglar. My favorite lines.
I love that.
Oh, my God. I mean, there's so many lines between those two. I couldn't stop laughing. I'm like, but there's chemistry between her and Nick Stabile, who plays Nick. But I saw chemistry with her and Tyler Christopher too.
I did too.
Because there's something about Nick in the role that he seems a little older than he does when Tyler plays it.
Oh,
which I feel like it makes it a little bit more. It seems like more of a more appropriate kind of coupling.
Interesting.
I agree.
Well, I mean, Nicholas is older than Morgan, so. That
Oh, there you go.
I'm all about it being inappropriate. I think the more inappropriate, the better.
Exactly.
I'm all about Christina and Parker. I love it.
Yeah, we've joked about you and Christina getting together. Yeah. Since, you make
I'm down. I'm down. Throw in another Corinthos.
Dante,
you're right.
Just throw them all in there.
It's not the Corinthos. That's funny. Yeah. Oh, my God, you're right. That's
just marking them off. I got a list.
Oh, my God, I love it.
There seems so many times during those scenes where it felt like Ava just wanted to get it on. Like, when they're all tired, like, Nicholas puts her arm around.
Really she's feeling
like,
it.
Yeah, she's like, let's just forget about getting out and just make out for a little while.
She is hotsy-totsy.
She is.
I was like...
I can see why her and Paul was like...
To get it on,
okay.
too.
Okay.
I loved them.
Yeah,
I'm sad that it kind of went a little...
Same here.
Yeah. Sour.
I liked them together. I liked them together. Yeah. So they couldn't talk crap. I almost cussed. Couldn't talk crap to each other.
Come on, James.
I know. I almost did it. I did, girl. But they were real with each other.
Right.
But they were also sexy with each other.
Yeah. They kind of just played with each other.
Yeah.
It was literally fun.
The thing is, Richard. He's hot. Period. Yeah. Number one, he's just hot. So his scenes with a lot of people are just, they just, they match. He's good with a lot of people. I'm like, I wouldn't go there. And then we have J. Sam, Hot on the Tail. And come in and save the day, kind of.
Yeah, where Huxley and his mom, she's like, okay. No, I mean, I was glad to see, like, we're kind of speeding that up, I guess. But now we're kind of dragging out. They're lost in the woods somewhere.
Listen, I laughed so hard when Ava was on tased.
Oh, yes.
I could not.
And she goes, was I just tased? She's like, was I just tased?
I just wish she would have said, don't tase me, bro.
I laughed so hard.
Yeah, I did laugh too. She's like, did you just tase me? Did you just tase me? I'm like, yeah.
I should have tased that.
Yeah, she did. I was so fine. Because Mara West actually does, she could do drama and comedy.
Oh, she's hilarious.
And you, but you've done, most of your scenes have been mostly drama, yeah. Obviously. But I mean, she could do comedy.
I know. I wish we got along better on the show because we could be so funny.
I know. Mother and daughter duo.
Except I'm always pissed.
You always
it's hard to be funny when you're pissed.
Yeah.
Now, you did get to do something that they're kind of crossing off all the boxes there for all the cast members. You got to do an outdoor scene. That
yes. I was so excited. There's more coming up. What's crazy is we filmed. You're not a fan.
We make fun of the outdoor scenes. All these all the same bench.
Oh, no, there's two benches.
There's two? Okay.
And do you
there are two benches.
Frank, there's two benches.
Oh, there's two benches. But you guys always, you must be out there and you're shooting and you comment like, boy, this fence is really just busted up. Why are we?
The fence is behind
you.
Do
you want to know the funniest thing ever?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's one scene coming up. Can I say anything? No, I can't. I tried. Sorry.
Well.
There is a scene outdoors that it took probably like 10 takes to get done. It was a little windy outside. Oh. And because we're in LA, there are palm trees in the park. And so they're wrapping all of the palm trees to make them look like anything other than a palm tree. And so there's also other trees in pots, just kind of like placed around. When the wind starts up, the trees fall over. So we're in the middle of scenes, like trying to get through them. Oh, the wind is going crazy. It's cold. Like, we're all kind of just freezing. Tree falls over in the middle of the scene. We try it again. Tree falls over in the middle of the scene. God. Like, I'm not kidding. Like, 4 or 5 times it happened. Uh-huh. And there was nothing we could do. It was the wind.
Right, yeah.
But we finally were like almost done with the scene. It was so exciting. Sat down on a bench and a leaf fell on my face. It just like, you know, it just like boop. Right here. And nobody called cut. I was like, I tried to get through the line. I was just like talking and talking and talking. And I got maybe like 2 more words out and I was like, okay, come on.
It's a leaf in my face.
Literally in my face.
we joke about the outdoor scenes where everybody comes in. It's just kind of funny. Yeah. It's like, it's like the same pathway. And it's all those, you see the houses back there and the busted fence. But you know, just 2 minutes.
Oh, there was a gardener. Like, it's just like everything that could go wrong was going wrong. It was hilarious.
Yeah, because there aren't any palm trees in New York.
No,
not at all. So you can't really have that. So they get there and they actually they see that the girl Margaret, I guess, was knocked out. But what did she charge with? But she came out to charge them with something.
I thought it was a fire poker.
Yeah,
I thought that too.
Yeah. It's like, so I was just like, what? My TV was
that
like, what?
That was too much for me.
That was gonna be. Now I love some Trent Dawson because I used to love him on Astroworld Turns. Mm-hmm. He was a great actor there, and he's not British in real life. So it was kind of funny to see him play this role over a statue though. I'm having a problem with the statue, the Naiad thing, weeping Naiad thing.
Yeah.
I see you guys in here the same problem too. I'm kind of like, really? That's the reason? I don't know.
Yeah, I thought he was after Nicholas.
No, he said it was her. It was her.
I mean, it feels like they're trying to set up some big summer adventure for all of them, but I feel like, is this the Weeping Naiad? Is that really? Well, I mean, I guess we had the Ice Princess.
And... Yeah, I was about to say, this is no Ice Princess. Yeah. But
on Days of Our Lives, we had an elephant, and that became the joke. Yeah. There were diamonds in an elephant, and everyone hated it. And my girl, Melissa Archer, is a friend of mine, an actress. She actually brought elephant on for us, and it was kind of funny. It's like that elephant was like, oh my god! As symbolic as the storyline was over, they smashed the elephant on screen. Like they smashed. We're like, yes, the elephant's gone.
So the elephant is no longer in the room.
No longer in the room. That's right. She's a comedian. Like for real. I'm like this weeping Naiad thing. I'm like, I don't know how much I'm like. Trent Dawson's a better actor. Yeah. I don't know what that's all about. So I'm just not sure about that.
And there's never going to be a scene where Nicholas actually gets to kick somebody's butt, right?
No. Yeah, he always gets his butt kicked.
Yeah.
I know. He's always got like a bruise somewhere on his face.
But they're drinking in a cabin or something right now. They found a bottle of booze, which made me happy, of course. So, you know, something to drink. And either they haven't eaten either that whole day, so they're going to be drunk fast.
Yeah.
Ooh, some sexy.
I think so.
When people are locked in the room with an alcohol, that's what always happens, apparently. Yes. You know,
nothing ever good happens in a cabin.
That's true. And you just got to cue the rain.
You would know.
I would know.
Yes, you would know. Your character would know. Yes. Okay, you do.
Right. Same difference, whatever.
And then the last couple of things, we'll take some phone calls, of course, with Miss Haley, so you can talk to her. But the last couple of things were Tracy, there was her month checkup. And so she called Dr. Finn to come over. Of course, Monica forgot her files at home, and they get into it.
Well, and then we've got that tying in there with Michael and Sabrina and the baby, which I'm like,
Sabrina, leave.
It's kind of like, we're really against the actress, of course. We love her. The baby's cute.
The baby is so cute.
The baby's very cute. All good points. But nothing's wrong with the baby.
No, but I will give it up for Sonny, because I felt like his reaction when Michael says that he wants to try to make it work, Sabrina, like, was the reaction for everybody. It was like,
he's like, huh? He's like, huh?
All right.
But Carly brought up some history. She was like, yes, it's karma, because I made Tony believe that Michael was my baby. See, they brought some history back from the early 90s, kind of like that.
Yeah, I was glad that Carly brought it up, but at the same time, I hate to defend Sabrina, but it's just like, Carly trying to say, what angle is she pulling? Sabrina actually is one of the few people that we've ever had on the show who isn't pulling an angle. We don't know that.
Something could happen next week that we have no idea.
That's true, but I mean, for what we've seen with Sabrina, is like, she is a good person. That's probably why she's boring. But at the same time, I'm like, Carly's trying to figure out her deal, and it's like, it's because you can't fathom that someone might actually not be as horrible as you.
Yeah, Carly was like, I wish I could hate her, but I can't. I'm like, that's like, well, yes, she could, but you really can't.
And to me, it proves how much she loves Michael more than Morgan, because, like, okay, no offense, Haley, but Kiki did both of them wrong, and then Carly loves you, so.
She just did both of them.
Yeah.
Period.
Yeah. Exactly. and then there's nothing said about that, and I'm like, it's because she loves Michael more. We've always known it, but this just said it.
Homeboy said it when he came out. He goes, Michael, I see why you're the favorite. You're my favorite, too. Now, I love that line that he said that Morgan said that, because, I mean, Michael is the favorite, obviously. Mm-hmm. Morgan's the second son, which you all know how that goes, like in The Godfather and stuff. He's the second son.
I was just watching that, like, a couple days ago. So
they're always the second son or the middle child. I'm a middle child, I don't know how that is. It's always like, the other ones get all the attention. The babies get all the attention. So Morgan, I see where Morgan feels. Mm-hmm. He's a perfect together of Carly and Sonny.
Yeah, he is perfect.
He's both of them.
Mm-hmm. He's a hot mess.
No. That's what happens when you put these two together. They make Morgan.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Now, I mean, Carly kept saying she's not going to meddle. As hard as it was going to be for her, I feel like that. She's like, all right, cut to tomorrow. She's meddling right away. I'm not going to meddle. Cut to meddling.
I agree.
Speaking of Carly and your relationship, how much longer do you think you're going to be able to keep your job at the Metro Court? Because you take a lot of breaks.
Oh, yeah, girl. When are you serving tables?
I got nothing.
Do you actually work?
It's absurd at this point. It used to be that I was always eating. Like, Kiki would show up in every scene with a to-go box. Like, I don't know what it was. Just like, or she was sitting at the Metro Court eating. Like, whatever it was, she was at Kelly's eating, or she was bringing Kelly's to someone to eat. Like, always. And now it's the fact that she's never doing her job. Like, there's always something, but I think it's funny.
It is funny.
I like to find the humor in things.
I just imagine, like, the manager for the Metro Court is just sitting right off camera, just looking at you, going, what?
It's like,
get to work.
Okay. Time will tell.
So let's take some phone calls, and a lucky caller will win something.
Ooh.
I'm not going to tell you which one it is.
A picture of Ladine.
Yes, of Ladine and Frank together.
Mm. Yeah. She wants one.
Count my part. Keep the Ladine part.
No.
It's Link until I die.
It's Link. That's right. So we'll put the number up and everything, and you guys have to call in and ask questions. If you can't keep it as brief as you can, let's make as many calls as we can. And it's 424-253-0749.
I got you.
Thanks. I'm going to say that loud anyway. Hey, don't want to hear my voice, Lexus. Everybody's Lexus. That's a Lexus Taurus in here. So,
Go, Lexus.
The one that's not psychotic. Yay!
Yeah.
Yay!
Now we have a phone call. Okay, let's do it.
All right. Hello, everyone. You are calling into AfterBuzz After Show General Hospital. Please say your name and where you're from.
It's Cheryl from South Carolina.
Oh, hey, my God.
Hi, Hayley. How are you?
I'm great. Mm-hmm. Thank you for asking. How are you doing?
I'm doing good.
Good.
I'm the one who said I thought you looked like Carly Schroeder and you would have been a better Corey Baldwin. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for that one. That puts a little pep in my step.
I feel like you need a dad, and Scotty needs an actual kid and not Franco.
No, that's like, a good point.
I like Franco, but he's a man. He doesn't need his daddy.
I actually love the storyline idea of having Scott with Franco and then Kiki, the pseudo-granddaughter. I think that's a great story.
Yes.
Good.
It was fun. I got to hang out with him before.
Together. And that is, I think, of all of my Franco personalities, Franco the dad to Kiki is the best storyline that I think he's ever had. He truly cares about her.
I love it. I love it because it also shows, like, his contrast. He's, like, this crazy artist, and he's all up in Nina's business, and then he'll go be just, like, the daddy, like, making smoothies.
Right, and you also get to see him interact with the little boy that plays Jake.
And that's
a dynamic that we've never had, is that, you know, like, the child with Franco dynamic, so...
I love it. I think, like, I don't want kids.
In Jake that he recognizes himself in Jake.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, a little bit of damage.
You need to have more scenes with Tracy Quartermaine because Jane Elliott is the bomb. And you guys, I could see her getting all up in your business because you're dating her son.
It would be my honor to have her in my business.
Yes. Totally.
I can't wait to see what happens between Kiki and Dylan. I'm over Kiki and Morgan. I think that is an accident looking for another place to happen.
I think that's generally the consensus. Yeah, but, you know, there's just a little part of me that kind of wants it to work. Aww. But then, like, Dylan's
just bring back Darby.
No. Oh, yeah?
Darby, that's right.
Jessica's a good friend of mine. She's a sweet girl.
We loved her. We loved Darby.
Yeah, love her.
Bring her on.
Well, she's hilarious. I like Darby, but I just don't want him with Kiki.
I see what you're doing. Mm-hmm. All right.
Mm-hmm. I'll let somebody else call. I just wanted to say hi.
It was a pleasure speaking with you.
I'm enjoying you on the
show. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Cheryl. Bye.
Bye.
We have another phone call.
Woo.
Alrighty, thank you for calling AfterBuzz TV's General Hospital After Show. Please say your name and where you're from.
This is Kelly, otherwise known as Maxie Forever from Canada.
Maxie Forever, that's right, from Canada. How are you?
Good, and by the way, the name is Kelly.
Okay, well, hey, Kelly. Yeah. Hi, Kelly. Sure. I'll call you whenever you want me to call you.
Whatever.
As you write. How are you? What do you want to say to Miss Haley?
I love you, darling.
Aw, thank you.
And that singing you did at the nurse's ball was spot on.
That's so sweet. Thank you. I know. I loved that number. And it's funny because I was so anxious about it before it happened. And then we got up there and we just kind of did it. And looking back on it, like, I'm a little proud of myself. I think it turned out all right. I felt like Katy Perry. Thank you.
And I am so waiting for Mr. James over there to really do a cuss word.
I'm all...
not a cuss word. I'm a Canadian. That's not a cuss word.
I know. I'm trying to be good, girl. Stop encouraging me. Customers come easy to me. I'm trying to be good.
I'm sorry.
I know. I love it. I may cuss for you later. Who knows? We'll see.
You need more scenes to change.
This is off the air. Yes. I'll send you a Snapchat or something. We cussing. I don't know. Something like that.
Okay.
Well, so glad you called in. I'm glad you watched us from Canada. We totally appreciate that. I mean, in all seriousness, we appreciate you tuning in to us.
Oh, I love this show.
And I love Canadians, so...
Me too.
Get your butt to Atlantic Canada. That's where I am. I cannot get to Montreal or Toronto.
Okay.
Oh,
wow.
I'm a single mom on a fixed income.
I understand that, girl. You're doing God's work. I would love to come to Canada. I've never been, so I'd love to come.
Get your butt to Atlantic Canada. That's where I am.
Okay.
I'm on PEI.
Got it, Kelly.
I don't know where that is. Dr. William.
Yeah, oh. Prince Edward Island is amazing. So, okay. You know, I've never been there, but I know people from there. So, okay. Yeah. Brad Richards,
well, if you don't know, where it is, talk to Will or Don.
Mm. Okay.
Know
where it is. All right. We'll do that. Well, thank you, Miss Kelly, for calling.
We'll see you on here, but because I'm on my my son's laptop, and you're like 30 seconds behind.
That's awesome.
Oh, 30 seconds behind. Yeah. Funny. Yeah. Well, thank you very much.
Have a great night, guys.
Bye.
Daquan wants to say that tell Hayley I like her and Kristen Alderson's friendship interaction on Twitter.
Thank you. Yeah, I love her. I mean, she is just a sweet girl. And we used to hang out. I'm sad that she moved away.
Yeah, I know. Next call.
Here we go. Thank you for calling AfterBuzz TV. You are live on the General Hospital After Show. Please say your name and where you're from.
Hello, everyone. This is Mike Riley from New York.
Hi, Mike Riley from New York. Hi, Mike. How are you?
I'm quite well, thank you. How is everyone?
Great.
Hi,
Hayley.
Good, good.
What'd you like to say, Miss Hayley?
I am curious how you feel about the rumor / fan opinion that Kiki is the presumed dead child of Nina and Silas, and if you would be interested in playing that turn in the storyline.
I would like that. Mm-hmm. I like the unexpected. I'm into that. I don't know if that's even so unexpected at this point because it's like kind of old news, but I love Maura West. So it would just break my heart a little bit not to have her as my mother anymore. Also because it's very flattering that people think I look like her. But I would love that because I also love to work with Michelle Stafford and, I mean, Michael Easton. You can't really, like, complain about having to be around Michael Easton. Yeah, that would be a really fun storyline. That's a good idea.
Well, I would like you to, and I think the fans would like you to, because Maura and Michelle play such great adversaries.
Oh, yeah.
And that's kind of died down a bit. And I love Maura West because when she's in a bind, you can, like, her smarminess comes out and you can read every thought that she has on her face. And I love that Michelle is the opposite. The crazier she gets, she just verbalizes everything. It's like verbal diarrhea. So I just love that mix of craziness and kind of mobster smarminess.
They're great.
And I would love to see, like, your, like, where your loyalties would lie, but...
Ooh, that's an interesting thought. I like that idea.
Me too.
Side note, the best scenes I think I've ever seen in my life were those catfight scenes during the nurse's ball and then Ava just terrific. Like sitting on the toilet. Like that was the best.
It was.
There's like a screen cap that's so funny.
Mike, wait a second. You are the winner of a signed picture from Miss Hayley. I'll have it right here on your night. So send me to GH Report on a private message. Send me your address and we'll send it to you.
Yeah, I'll send you my real name so that you don't put my grass.
They're like, who's
thanks,
this?
Who's
that?
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for calling.
Thanks.
Have a great night.
You too.
Give
it another phone call. Some interesting questions. These are some good questions.
That's a good one.
That was a good one. I get how, I mean, okay. Oh, bye-bye.
No.
Lots of calls. Like, don't worry.
Because it would be nice with that, as they're talking about, because that's always been kind of rumored around for a little while. Because I feel like Kiki's storyline has always been more like men problems in her life, whether it be with Michael or Morgan. But to have like her own storyline that's just kind of generated from that, I think it would be really cool to have Kiki have a storyline that's just kind of driving itself.
Yeah, that would be awesome. I think the closest we've gotten to that was Silas dying. But that was just kind of like, be miserable. Like that was the general note there.
And you're like, I can't because you miss Michael, of course.
Exactly.
You're like, I can be miserable.
Yeah,
so, yeah.
Something like a little exciting. Yeah, that would be really interesting.
We have a phone call.
Hello. You've called into AfterBuzz TV. Please say your name and where you're from.
Hi, this is Kimberly from Maryland.
Hey, hi, Kimberly from Maryland. We know you. How are you?
I'm fine. I have two questions.
Okay.
I have one for Hayley and one for you, James.
Cool.
My question for Hayley is. Do you think that it would have been better if Kiki came up on her own to break up with Morgan instead of having Ava do it?
For sure.
Good question.
Yeah. I mean, that was Ava's idea. That was all Ava. But she was saying what I think Kiki is a little bit reserved about. That Kiki kind of knows that Morgan's no good for her, but it's hard to admit. You know, when you're so invested in someone, it's hard to see it for what it really is.
Oh, yeah.
that's good. I like that. That's a good question.
And okay. you're, and my next question. for James. Okay. James, do you watch Grace and Frankie?
Yes, I do.
Because did you see the episode with Jane Fonda using the vibrator?
Oh, yes. I did see that. Oh, my God, that was so funny. Yes, it was hilarious. That show is the bomb. I love that show so much. All four of them, the two guys, and her, they're all so good on that show.
Yeah.
They're so good. Well, thank you, Ms. Kimberly, for calling in, as always.
Thank you. You guys have a nice day.
All right.
Bye.
We're going to take one last call. It's going to be really quick, though. Take one last call.
All right, here we go. General Hospital After Show. Please say your name and where you're from.
Hey, it's Jamel calling from Brooklyn. Happy Pride, everybody.
Hey, happy Pride to you too, Jamel. So quickly, what is your thing to Miss Haley over here?
No, I just wanted to ask her, how was it working with Michelle Stafford and you know, in regard to working with her young wrestlers and also working with her General Hospital? Yeah. And I love that you work with Mara West, so you work with two of my favorites from CBS, so how is it working with those two?
I'm lucky. I'm really lucky. I get to work with, like, the best ladies in the game. I can't say enough nice things about either of them. Like, I could just keep going, and it would be almost boring. But Michelle is awesome because she keeps you on your feet. She is hilarious, and she's always coming up with stuff. Like, we'll do a couple different takes of the same scene, and it's never the same. Mm. So it's fun working with her because you got to kind of keep up.
Well, you worked with Arlene Davidson, Michelle Sapp, and Mark West. Those are all heavy hitters from CBS Daytime. So I'm just you are lucky, and you're doing a wonderful job too. And I love
Thank
it.
Thank you.
So,
I know Arlene Davidson is the bomb. I can't say enough nice things about her.
So talented. Yeah,
I was going to say, I didn't just start liking Kiki. I liked it for a long time, and I still liked it from straight through. So I like what you do with Kiki and how fast you are and how you read your mother, too, and gave me a freeze when she did you wrong. I like that.
Yeah, that's like the theme of their relationship.
Yes.
Well, there's a lot of that.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, thank you, Jamel, for calling in, and we'll talk to you soon. Of course, thanks for watching always.
Yeah, well, you know what? I love the show. I got Game of Thrones on pause, the big night.
I'm honored. Yes. I'm about to, like...
Yeah, we're talking about that after the before the show. Yes, the finale. Well, thank you, Jamel. You take care. Hold on to Brooklyn for me.
I will. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
So thanks, everybody, for some great questions, you guys.
I know.
I mean, great questions, you guys, calling in. And, I mean, thanks for, of course, watching us and everything. Thanks for coming on the show. Mm-hmm.
Thank you for having
You're
me.
Welcome back anytime.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna take you up on that.
You and Robert, we're going to get you guys on together.
Yes.
I'm game.
Okay. And you'll have to do a duet for us since it's so
She's like,
Why about that?
Let's think of a song.
I just don't want to make your ears bleed.
And she's now your friend. She's now your friend, lady over there. She's now your friend. Yes, it works. So, Ms. Haley, tell people
now I can sleep tonight.
Tell folks on that camera where they can find you on social media.
You guys can find me on Twitter at Hayley Erin, HayleyErin, and then on Instagram, HayleyErin13.
Very
good. That's 1-3.
Okay. Well, why thank you for that. Yes. Frank, you start with you.
You can follow me on Twitter at HappyGoJackie, and then check me out every Tuesday night at 10 o'clock at my improv team, Max, at Iowa West here in Los Angeles.
Hi, guys. You can find me on Twitter at Ladine_Harvey and Facebook, Ladine Corinthos Harvey.
Hey, guys. You can always find me at LACRETIALYON anywhere on the internet since there is only one, and be sure to stay tuned for the Restless Wrap-Up right as we get out of here.
And then, of course, I'm James Lott Jr. You can follow me everywhere on the interwebs at James Lott Jr. And stay tuned for Bold Breakdown tonight. I have Heather Tom, 5-time Emmy winner, Heather Tom, sitting with me later on tonight, 8 o'clock. Thank you very much. See you next time.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.